guest here today, my BFF right here, Franny. Some of you guys know her from her channel when she used to have one. But she's in my channel today, finally, for the first time.
Wow, it's the first time.
Yeah, forever. When she had her channel, she would always, like, when we would do videos together, she would always be like, oh, well, when Jenny gets her channel, we'll do one on her channel. When Jenny gets her channel, we'll do a video on her channel.
And I deleted mine.
And now I have a channel and she deleted hers. But anyway, today we're going to do a get ready with us. We don't know exactly where we're going after we get ready. I don't know, but we are going to get ready, answer questions, and show you guys a few new things that we haven't tried ourselves that we just wanted to try, you know, with you guys. So, let's get started. Let's see. All right, so I'm gonna prime my eyes.
I already did my eyebrows.
You already did your eyebrows?
Yeah, and I'm gonna put moisturizer again because I'm just really, really dry.
Moisturizer.
And I'm using the Daily Hydration Moisturizer from e.l.f.
Nice.
I told you, I'm really liking this.
Yeah. There's one that I got.
Mm-hmm.
I should have grabbed it. I don't know what it's at. There's this honey one that I got in it's in my Sephora subscription.
Mm-hmm.
And I really like it. And it's on the back there. I should have grabbed it. I'm going to prime my eyes. I'm going to use this one. This one is a Too Faced eyeshadow primer. We do have some questions that we're going to be answering in just a minute. As soon as I put this on my eye because I can't read my eyes.
I'm going to do this makeup fixing mist from Pixie, which you're going to try out today.
Yes, I am. I have it right here.
It has like a rose, like a rosy smell. I really like it. Like, it's good for like hydrating the skin or just like refreshing throughout the day, stuff like that. So,
you smell it? It's not good. It's not as intense. I was telling her because we went to Target earlier, and I was telling her that I tried the new. Well, it's not really new, but it's been out for a while. But it was new for me. The Maybelline spray.
Oh yeah. You showed it to me.
I really like it. I just don't like the smell. And she's like, try this one. You like this
one? I'm priming with the same one as you.
Good friends keep the light. All right, so I'm just gonna jump into my first color. I'm gonna go in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Prisms palette. I'm gonna go in with the color Unity, this one right here, and I'm just gonna apply it all over my eye.
Unity. Mm-hmm. And I'm trying Jenny's Huda Beauty palette. I haven't tried this one. This was the Desert Dust palette, so feel free to like it.
You're gonna love it.
And I'm just gonna start with Desert Sand, just to use it as a base.
What kind of look are you going for?
I'm going to try to do like a halo eye, and I'm going to try to do like glitter in the center of my eye, and then just focus a little bit darker color on the outside.
I think it's going to look really nice, because she has those big eyelids.
Let's see.
Situation that I don't have.
I always say I'm going to do something, and I end up doing something completely different. This has become like my favorite eyeshadow brush for something.
Is that the E27? Yeah. Oh my god, I love that brush.
Yeah, I love this brush so much.
I love that brush. The first question, this was actually directed to her.
Oh god, how awkward.
Yes, it's gonna be directed to you. You kind of talked about it at the beginning of the video.
Okay.
They want to know, the people that followed you before, why don't you have a YouTube channel anymore and will you be back?
So I took off my YouTube June of this year, July. I want to say July, yeah,
July.
Something like that. Mainly because YouTube is honestly a full-time job. It feels like that some ways because it takes time to sit down, record it, edit it. Because I mean, you don't want to put out bad quality videos. You want to put good quality videos. So it was getting really exhausting. I have a normal 40-hour job, so does Jenny. But it was getting exhausting for me personally, and on top of it, I don't have the space. Like, she has a whole entire room she can use. I don't have the space. I was literally recording in my dining room. So
when I tell you guys, it was a very small space.
It was very small.
We could literally hug each other and just do our makeup on each other. Like, that's how small it was.
It was very tight. And then I also realized, like, I wanted to focus on some other things right now. So I just felt like I needed a break. And instead of just leaving a channel there that wasn't gonna be anything posted, I just decided to take it off. And then if I do decide to start again, when the moment's right, when I have the space, because I'm still in my apartment, then the time will come. I will maybe do it again. Who knows? I'm not sure yet.
I am really excited about that. I really hope that it's very soon, because you are the bomb.
Oh, that's great, girl.
Alright, so I'm going to add a transition color. I'm going to use this one right here. This one is from MAC. This one is soft brown. I'm just going to apply it on my crease and just a little bit higher.
I'm like doing my makeup and not explaining. So after I went in with Desert Sand, which is right here, more of a skin tone color, I'm going in with Eden. And I'm just focusing on the crease right now.
I feel like Eden looks different on your skin island because of your skin tone.
Yeah.
You're like a little bit more lighter than me.
Yeah.
So it looks a little bit more like intense.
Oh, okay.
More peachy.
Oh, I got you.
Thing. Yeah.
How does it come off for you?
More brown.
Oh.
Like more like it almost like if I apply so much, it almost looks like a brick color.
Oh.
Yeah.
It works for everybody.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, either way, it looks really nice.
So I'm going to go in with a little bit more of a tapered brush. This is from Morphe and M411. And I'm going to go in with the color Amber because I'm trying to warm up the crease area.
The next question was, if we can take a trip together, where would we go?
We were just talking about this. It's really hard to decide, but I think we would go somewhere in Asia, right?
Yeah, because we've both been wanting to go to, like,
I want to go to, like, Thailand. I really like their culture, their food. That'd be awesome.
I've never tried Thai food.
You've never tried Pad Thai?
Yeah, try Pad Thai.
It's really good. Really, really good.
But I mean, just like the place looks really pretty. Like,
oh yeah,
visit.
It's beautiful. Yeah.
There's a friend of mine who went to Thailand and she was uploading photos. Oh my gosh, so pretty.
It's beautiful. I mean, the places on earth are beautiful. I also have seen pictures of Vietnam. Very nice.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah. So it might be hard to decide, but right now, somewhere in Asia for sure.
Somewhere in Asia. That would be nice. What's your favorite food? Our favorite food.
Is that more like, are we talking about from a specific country or type of food?
The question just was, what's you guys' favorite food?
If it's like not actually like country wise, I would say my favorite kind of type of food is seafood. I like any kind of seafood, and by anything I mean like octopus and calamari, anything.
Nice.
And if we're talking about country, I really, really like Chinese food. I love Chinese food.
Oh my goodness.
I can repeat it every day of the week.
I very much agree. I mean, I wasn't sure, again, like you with the question.
Mm-hmm.
I can say like a dish, maybe?
Yeah, say a dish, yeah.
It would be like Mexican food and it's enchiladas.
That's like, what a surprise, Jenny.
Enchiladas are like my favorite Mexican dish ever. With some rice and beans.
Ooh.
And a Coca-Cola, forget it. Ice.
The Mexican Coca-Cola.
The Mexican Coca-Cola. Yes, absolutely, that's like,
yes,
like my favorite kind of
but food. I always like trying new foods, you know, so
yeah,
it always changes what I like. I'm pretty open.
I think that's something that we both have, that we're pretty open
yeah,
to like eating anything. Only thing I don't like, and I'm gonna say it straight up, is fish. But I like shrimp and I like crab.
You like crab?
I like crab, but like I don't
crab
like
legs and everything.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't like fish though.
Yeah.
Like, especially when it's a whole fish.
Oh, yeah.
No, I just can't do that. Fish is not.
Yeah, I totally get it too.
Not my thing.
Yeah, it's not for everybody.
Oh, I'm sorry, you guys. I went like to the next color.
You go first.
I'm gonna go to the peach palette. I'm gonna grab the color Pure, which is this color right here, and I'm just gonna use a PK 36 brush from Morphe and just apply it on my crease.
How do you say this?
I say oud. Odd.
O-U-D.
O-U-D.
Right here. Okay, this color right here. I'm going in and I'm darkening even more my crease, and I'm using an e.l.f. crease brush, and it's because I really like how tiny it is. It really gets like into your crease, you know?
That's a good one.
Yeah, I really like it.
It kind of, this one's a little bit more fluffier.
Yeah, I don't want it to be fluffy.
That's like more
really want to be focused, yeah.
Another question that they asked us was, do we have nicknames for each other?
Oh yeah, definitely.
We do. I call her Bruja.
Yeah.
Or Brujita.
Yeah.
Bruja is when, for example, she did something and she didn't invite me.
The shade.
Then it's Bruja.
Yeah.
But if it's like I've been gone or I haven't seen her or whatever, it'll be Brujita.
Yeah, and the ironic thing is I was explaining to her, I'm Puerto Rican, and I was born in a town in Puerto Rico called Guayama. And each town over there has like a mascot, kind of. So for people from Guayama, they're usually called brujos, brujas, which means witches, 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 because there's no male tense of witch, right?
I don't think so.
Yeah. Brujos. I know, but not in English. You're a witch either way. Either way, anyhow, so it was funny that she would call me that because since I was born in that city, that's what we would be called. Anyhow.
Oh my goodness.
We're not good at vocabulary today, Jenny.
You answered the second question, which was, where are we from?
Oh, okay, yeah. So I was born in Miami, Puerto Rico, so I'm Puerto Rican.
I was born in Fresno, California, so I'm from Cali, y'all. I don't think they use y'all.
No, they do not. I don't think they do
not.
But I was in Puerto Rico till the age of 4. And then I moved to Worcester, Massachusetts. And was there until the age of 14, 15. And then I moved to Kissimmee, Florida. Was there until I got married 3 years ago. And now I'm in Tampa, Florida.
And well, like I said, I'm from Fresno, California, and I moved to Florida when I lived there my whole life, and then I moved to Florida when I got married 3 years ago, and yeah. Move the next. There was another question here that had something to do with. Oh, how did Franny and I meet?
When I had Instagram, which I don't have social media anymore, we were just mutual friends.
Mm-hmm.
And we were noticing that we had like a lot of similarities. Like we got married a week apart?
A week apart,
exactly.
I got married first and then
yeah.
We got married.
She got married 12, 13, 14. I got married 12, 20, 14.
Mm-hmm.
We had almost the same kind of dress. We both had black hair. Your last name's Bensicourt. Mine is Boucourt. And we both love makeup. So I'm who's this chick?
I'm gonna stalk her.
So we were stalking each other.
We were stalking each other because I was going through her stuff and I'm like, we have so much like in common.
Yeah, we have a lot in common. So then we finally decided to like meet up in December. Was it December 2015? No, 2016.
Wasn't it 2015?
No, 2016.
Because
November 2016.
It was 15.
No, because we just did a year of getting of
you know
knowing
what?
Each other.
You're right.
Yeah, so yes. It was 2016, and we went to Busch Gardens, and we met for the first time.
And it was really nice. So then I got to meet your husband there.
Yeah, my husband was there too, and they met each other.
Yeah, mine's working like always.
Oh yeah, that's how we met.
How did we meet our husbands?
You go first.
Okay, so I met my husband. through social media as well. I met him on Instagram when Instagram had just started, which was
a while back.
So that's how we met. The story is extremely long, so I'm not gonna get into details.
So the video is now gonna be like an hour long.
more like 3 hours long if I say that story. But yeah. It's a very, very long story, and yeah, we met through there. I don't know if you guys remember Kik, but that's how we started talking. Before direct message, before WhatsApp, it was Kik.
Yeah.
Back in the day. Hold on, before I continue, I'm gonna go in with the color Summer Yum from the peach palette, this one right here.
And I'm just getting a little bit of concealer, if any concealer works. And I'm gonna clean up the middle of my eye so I can put a glitter on. And I think I'm gonna go with this glitter right here called Nefertiti. So is it my turn?
Right, yeah, your turn.
Okay. So I met my husband also through social media, but we kind of did meet in person first. So there was a get together at a Dave & Buster's, like a big group of people. And everybody took a picture at the end of it. And there was so many people tagged. I had met so many people, I just didn't know who I met. So I started like, all the people that were tagged, I'm like, request. And I ended up requesting him, and he's like, oh, who's this hot girl requesting me? This is what he said, okay? This is what he said. These are my words.
Your wife in like 4 years.
These are my words. So he like totally accepted me, which usually he wouldn't accept strangers unless he met them.
You know what? That is very true.
Yeah.
Because when I had met you, when, you know, we had a conversation for the first time on Instagram, I'm like, I mean, the next thing to do is to request a husband as well.
Yeah.
Since we're going to meet eventually one day. I requested him and he denied me.
Yeah. I didn't know that. He never told me that.
Yeah. And I don't think it was because he didn't know who I was.
Yeah.
And then eventually I guess he found out and then he sent me the request.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay.
So once I requested him, he commented on one of my pictures and he's like, I like your serious look, something like that. I don't remember. It was something, you know, trying to hit on me. I'm like, oh, thanks, I guess. And then I had done like this little group to go to Busch Gardens, and he's like, hey, I live like in Tampa, I'll go to Busch Gardens too.
Okay.
And he ended up saying, what's your number? And I'm like, I don't give my number out to everybody. So I'm like, here's my cake. He's like, I don't have cake. And then he made a cake, and then we started talking. We met at Busch Gardens. We hit it off. We're good friends, and then shortly started dating after that. Here we are.
Married.
Here we are. Married. Yeah, exactly. So that's how we met.
This is an interesting one. What's your favorite alcoholic drink?
What kind of questions are these, people? I'm not an alcoholic.
I'm not an alcoholic either.
No, I'm kidding.
What is?
You go, girl.
I like sweet stuff.
Does that have to be like a mixed drink?
But I mean, whatever you...
I like tequila.
Yeah,
and I'm not the Mexican water.
I like mojitos. I think that's like my favorite drink.
Really?
I like any kind of mojito.
I don't like... that has vodka in it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like vodka.
Yeah, I think you're more of a shot girl.
Yeah. I don't even like straight rum, straight vodka. I don't like any of that. I just really like tequila straight or Long Island. They're good.
Long Islands are like... Yeah,
that's like happy juice. Really, you have to be careful as well.
The next color I'm also gonna grab, it's from the Too Faced. It's called Charmed, I'm sure. It's this one right here at the bottom. It's like dark, like a darker brown.
Since I had cleaned up the center of my eye, I went in with Nefertiti, a small, it's supposed to be a concealer brush, but I just used it for that. And I'm just blending around it right now. You gotta blend.
Gotta blend those edges. Oh, this one's cute. Let me see if I can see.
Once again, not saying what brush I'm using. I'm using a Morphe M518.
I think we're just so into the doing our makeup that we kind of forget.
I'm just into this palette. I really like this palette. I'm gonna go buy it.
See, I should have got you that. I don't know why. I thought about
No, I like the palettes you got me.
Like, no, but I thought about it last minute.
Oh, like, I get you, yeah.
Like, anyway.
But this one's really, really pretty.
That palette is really nice. I really wanted to get the other one too, the rose gold.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
They had it on sale for a little bit, or no?
I don't think so. I don't think so. This question is kind of cute, I think. What do we like about each other?
You go.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, me.
Why don't you go fuck me? Just kidding.
Just kidding.
Before I answer that, I'm gonna go into the Morphe palette. This huge thing. I know, like, it's so huge. I'm gonna go in with this color called Spine. It's blue. This one right here.
It's called Spine?
Yeah. Interesting name for a color, huh?
When I think of spine, I don't think of that.
I mean, yeah.
I'm obsessed with this mess that is.
And I'm just gonna darken up my crease. The thing that I like about Franny is that I like a person who's very, like, honest and, like, honest with me. Like, that she's not afraid to tell me something if she needs to tell me something.
Yeah.
You know, you have your friends that are like, oh, well, I kind of didn't want to tell you because I don't want to make you feel bad, so I just let it be, and then you just made a fool of yourself. This one here, I know that she won't do that. Like, yeah. It's like, Jenny, no. This and this and this and this.
Yeah.
It's like, that's one of the things. I think your honesty towards me is something I really appreciate.
Thank you.
And she's always pretty much, there's a lot of things that I've gotten through, and like, you've been there for them.
Yeah.
And I appreciate the fact that you have been there for me. Even if, sometimes she doesn't even say anything. She just hears me go on and on and on and on and on and on.
Yeah.
And that is not like only like a friendship thing. It's a beautiful quality.
No,
I think it's a really beautiful quality to have. Because not everybody has that.
Yeah.
And you know, even before we started like filming, there was something very personal that I'm not gonna talk about on camera, but you know, really deep for me, and she was just like, just there. Just there, you know. And
yeah.
I just love it.
You're also very honest. That's a good quality about you. But I like her, just, you're always like upbeat. Like, you always have a good spirit. You're not negative. Like, not saying like you don't have negative moments, everybody does, but you're like really positive and you try to look like the best in everything. So I really like that. I like the positive energy.
Positive energy is always good.
Yeah, because it's good to be around people that are positive. Like, it brings positivity towards you. So.
Yeah.
I like that. I am gonna go on to foundation. So I changed my foundation.
Yeah, girl, you can move forward.
So I used to really, really be diehard Born This Way, because I still love that foundation till this day. But I tried a drugstore one, Maybelline Fit Me. Back in the day, I used to use this. They changed the formula now, so I like it way more.
I hear that's what they did.
I like it way more. And this one's from normal to oily because I have combination skin. So I'm shade 128, warm nude. A little light for me, but when I bronze, it's barely noticeable. So I put a little bit of that in, and then I'm gonna mix in a little bit of liquid highlighter, which I'll use the Cover Effect Celestial drops.
Do you like those drops?
Yeah, I like them a lot.
I've been like wanting to try it. I told you they also sent me one of those on my Sephora subscription.
Yeah.
And I'm just always like afraid, because I don't know if it's something that you have to kind of like put it like, how do you say it? Like, it has to be with like your tone of, like your skin tone type of thing. But you can just mix it as it goes.
I mean, if you mix it with your foundation, it's pretty easy. It could be like, if you're using it more like a straight highlight on your cheeks, yeah, it could sometimes not look good with your skin tone. It just depends which shade it is.
Right.
I think this is one of your lightest shades. Since I'm more light skin, like, it works for me. You know, somebody that's probably darker skin or more tan probably wouldn't look good.
Right.
Yeah.
Color correct first, because I have a lot of darkness.
I'm using this e.l.f. color correcting stick. It's kind of like orange tone, so it cancels out those blue, dark purple kind of issues on my face. I look super white.
Yeah, it will look different, like, once we see it, like, in the camera. I mean, in the camera, the computer. All right, so I'm gonna add some pigment. I'm gonna use the color Silver Fog. This one is from MAC. This one is from the Holiday Collection 2000. When did it? 2014.
Yeah,
it's been a while. Yeah, it's been a while. So I don't know, you might find it, you might not.
I'm going for the ghost look, so.
For the ghost?
Yeah, I'm super white.
You're so light complected.
I'll warm it up with bronzers, but we'll see. Bronzer saves lives.
Bronzer saves lives.
It really does. Especially if you're more pale. Like, it really warms up the skin.
I did have an interesting question. Hold on, let me
I like poured too much foundation. Way too much foundation.
Yeah, because I'm like, your foundation's already done, and then
because I like putting a lot of foundation on.
It's like my favorite part. The next question was, would you two do the $30 outfit challenge, and how long have we been friends?
What's the challenge? Like, you do an outfit just like $30 the whole entire outfit, like jewelry, shoes.
I want to say yeah.
That's hard.
That's really hard.
I mean, I would try it.
It's really hard though. I think it would be very difficult. Whoa.
What happened?
It's so intense. I think I wet my brush way too much.
I'm using Fit Me concealer, and it's in shade 20 sand. I'm just highlighting the face with that. Oh, and what was another question? Like,
part B was just how long have we been friends?
We hit a year. Just this month.
This December, yeah?
December.
What was it? December 15th, I think it was.
Yeah.
Why did it close that? I need that.
That light just fell off this one.
Huh?
Oh god, it did. I'm like, what? Why does it look like it's on top of us?
It wanted to give us a little bit more intensity?
Yeah. Probably.
Okay, Laura Mercier for baking.
She's scared to use.
I'm scared to use any other powder because I used this one, the Airspun one. And I like used it how I used Laura Mercier, like I packed it on and I looked so, so crusty. So I need to give it a second shot. But right now, like, I'm really scared to use it.
Yeah.
And it smells so strong, smell it.
Woo!
Really, really
yeah,
strong.
No.
Smells like Viejita.
It does.
Viejita perfume, yeah.
I wanted her to try the Patrick Star one, but she's like, I don't know.
It's just because I had a bad experience with that one. And I've just been really scared ever since. So I'm gonna use an R10 Morphe brush to bake.
I really like this e.l.f. Brush cleanser that Franny just introduced me to, because I normally use the Clinique brush cleanser. It's like one of my favorites. I've been using it for like ever. But then she was spraying her brushes earlier before we started, and I'm like, smells good.
A girl's on a budget. It's only like $3, and I think they did like now a super sized one, which is like 2-in-1, and it's like $6.
Oh my god, yeah. It's perfect.
It's worth it, guys. Worth it.
Now I'm gonna move on to eyeliner. I'm gonna be using my Makeup Forever Aqua Black Gel Liner with a Morphe M207 brush. You know, I love gel liners, but the only thing I don't like about them is that they get dry. Really fast. And then when you put the oil in there.
I put that in it.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
I put the tart oil, the Morocco.
I feel like it's too, it makes it too watery. That's why I don't do that, yeah.
I need to do like a closer mirror situation here.
It just has worked for me thus far. So I'm gonna contour with this. It is a highlight and contour palette from IBY Beauty.
I've never heard of that brand.
It came in my BoxyCharm when I used to have BoxyCharm, and I've loved it ever since, honestly.
Love it, love it, love it.
And I'll go with the Morphe M460 brush.
See what other questions we have up in here. Okay,
by the way, I'm using the contour 1 and contour 2 shades, these two. And I like those because they have like gray tones, and that's what I like to use to contour my face.
Coming up and I still haven't decided what color contacts I
want to
get next. Getting tired of.
I used to use honey a lot.
I was thinking of getting honey.
Yeah.
But people are like, you go green because green can match your hair. But guess what, guys? She is changing her hair color. That's the plan. I made my decision. I'm going to dye my hair. I've been redhead for like going on like 3 years. And I'm like.
Yeah, because you did it right after you got married, right?
Yeah. So. I think it's gonna go bye-bye very soon, so.
Does it make you scared?
A little bit, because, I mean, I've had red hair for such a long time.
Yeah.
But I'm just like, it's so much maintenance to like, you know, do it.
Yeah.
It's just, ugh. Just dye black and.
I had gone blonde for those that did follow me on social media and YouTube, and it was too much breakage, so I went back to black.
Black looks good on you.
Yeah, everybody told me because of my skin color, black doesn't wash me out as much, so
I went back to black.
I know. Nice. Yeah.
I used to have black
hair. It's
too.
Easy maintenance, you know?
I know. Just dye it and then that's it.
And it's so easy for like any kind of hair accessory that has to do with hair, like extensions, stuff like that. Just jet black. And that's what I like about the color.
What do you mean you don't have lashes?
Well, I mean, I do have lashes, but these are like not the lashes I would want to wear.
Why?
Because these are like my natural look lashes type of deal.
Oh.
And these lashes are these ones. They're cream bees. Oh, these are like your favorite ones.
Yeah, they're my fave. From Coco Lashes.
So we're gonna be using I'm gonna pop on these lashes. These are the Coco Lashes Queen Bean. She like literally uses these lashes all the time. It's like me with my MacBook.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
I'm not saying what I'm doing. It's horrible. I use the e.l.f. angled contour brush, and I just like how tapered it is. It just takes the curve of my nose perfectly. And then I'm just going with a fluffier brush. This is supposed to be a e.l.f. Flawless Concealer brush, but I'm using it just to soften up the edges of my contour.
Another question that we were asked, Franny, is what do we do for a living?
I'm a legal assistant, and I've worked at the law firm that I'm at for, I'm about to hit a year, but I've been a legal assistant for 6 years now. Going on 7, so.
Is it similar? A legal assistant is a paralegal,
it's
right?
Essentially the same thing as a paralegal, yeah.
I am a medical assistant. I have been doing that for a very long time.
A very long time.
When I moved to Florida, I used to work at a primary doctor. And then I moved on to another job, and this is with a kidney specialist. We do like, you know, we take care of the kidneys and dialysis and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And yeah, I really, really enjoy it. I work with an amazing doctor.
That's good. It's important to like who you work with.
Oh yeah.
And I can say the same for my boss. He's a great guy.
I'm gonna move on to my face. I'm gonna be using this Maybelline Instant Pore Eraser. This one I use just on my nose and here because that's where I have like crazy pores. And then for my whole face, I think I'm gonna do Too Faced. Hangover RX. So I'm going to try this foundation. This one is from Maybelline Superstay Full Coverage Foundation. I have never ever tried this one before. I've tried other ones. There's one from Maybelline that I really like, and it's called Airbrush or something like that. It works really well.
Airbrush?
Yeah, it works really, 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 really nice. And then I forget that this, you just do this. I keep twisting it. I don't know why I did that. I got this foundation online, so I don't know if it's going to...
You got it online?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's scary.
Yeah, they don't have it at the store.
You don't? Wow. Mm-hmm. Is it because it's an exclusive or something?
Mm-hmm. Oh. I got it in Ulta. For concealer, I'm gonna be using this one. This one is from Maybelline. It's the Master Conceal. I really like this stuff. I always go back and forth with this one in my MAC. MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. And I always get it like a shade or two lighter than my skin tone. Setting powder. It's so messy. But you see it's yellowish.
Which are you using?
Born This Way.
Yeah. So would like Laura Mercier be your favorite? Patrick Starr, which one's
oh
your favorite?
Oh my god. Okay, so I think I'm gonna go by numbers. So I think Born This Way is my one.
Really? So you have that, and god, I'm gonna forget the name. There's this palette from MAC that's got sold out so quickly.
Which one?
Is
it the one with all the neutrals?
Yeah,
no,
I was wondering if you had it. I was gonna ask you about it, cause like, people were so crazy about it.
I was gonna get it, but every time I would go in, it was like, sold out.
Yeah, even online.
So
for Black Friday, I was gonna try to get it, and I'm like, okay, well, it's not there. So
yeah.
Forget about that.
I know. I tried, but and then never, you know, once it's sold out, and then you go like.
They take a while to restock.
To restock and. Armpit stink.
That was so random. I feel like my armpit smell. Just a statement.
For blush, I'm gonna use the color Mellow Wine. This one is from Wet n Wild. And I'm gonna use a Morphe brush. I just don't know the name because since I use it so much, it fades away. So for highlight, I'm gonna go into this color right here. This is the Wet n Wild palette that they have. It has like really awesome colors. And I'm going to go into the color Sweet Pony, and I'm gonna mix it with a blushing azalea. Yeah.
Potato.
I spray my palette, not my brush. I'm weird.
Either way, it works. You made that rain. Literally. I'm gonna go back to working on my lower lash line. And
wow.
I'm gonna do that with a pencil brush. Very pretty.
That's really nice.
Pencil brush, where's pencil brush? Pencil brush. Why do things disappear on me? Oh, it's right in front of my face the whole entire time. I'm gonna go in with amber again. So what's your favorite makeup product right now?
Oh god. like specifically?
Overall. You always know you're gonna go grab for it.
Right now. It can be anything?
Yes, anything.
I have been using a lot of my like peach palette.
Really?
Like a lot lately.
So that's your go-to palette?
Yeah. Actually, no, hold on. No. I'm sorry, I take that back. The Prism palette.
Really?
That's the one that I've been like on. Maybe because it's the newest one I've gotten.
Oh, it is?
I think, yeah. Like I've been using it a lot for like my makeup looks.
And what do you think makes it such a good palette?
I was, you know how I do my little mini tutorials on Snap?
Uh-huh.
With that palette, I'm able to like do like different kind of looks. I can do something pinkish. I can do something purple.
Oh, so it's mainly the choice of color.
Yeah, like, you know, there's so many looks that you can do with only that palette. And I feel like lately that's what I've been using. Because I did catch myself, actually. I'm like, wait, can I use this palette again? When I normally am kind of like just mixing stuff around and trying different things.
Yeah.
What's yours?
That new marketing one? Create. What is it? The one you just used.
It's Dare to Create.
Dare to Create. I really like it.
It's really
actually useful, the fact that they made the transition colors in such big cans.
Mm-hmm. At first I thought they were blushes.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's nothing against you. Like, there's no rule. You can do however you want, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, what do I want to do? I want to bronze my face. Totally forgot that. I bought this new butter bronzer from Physician's Formula. And everybody's like raving about it.
Mm-hmm.
It looks very pretty. And then it has like a little.
That's an interesting.
It's a pad. It doesn't have bristles.
Oh.
Don't like that.
That's different.
I feel like that would not blend well. Takes me back to the 90s.
What color?
So I'm just getting used to this e.l.f. blending brush. Warm up the whole entire face.
I don't know what I'm gonna do to my lower lash line. Palette, and I'm gonna grab the color Inspire, which is right next to my spine. It's like a nice blue. I'm gonna do Expressed. Yeah, it's like a more like purple color situation.
So I'm going in with the 9B palette from Morphe, and I'm gonna use like a mauve blush. I'm gonna combine these two, and this is just. It's supposed to be a contour brush, but I like the density of it, so I just use it for my blush.
What did you think about the Fenty palette?
I just used one color. I think it's overhyped. It's not bad.
No, but let me tell you
it's
something.
Not bad. It's just overhyped.
Yeah, there's some colors that need to be extremely wet before you apply them. Just so you know. Yeah.
Put a little bit too much blush. I need to blush it out. I am in another world right now, people.
Yeah, that palette, there's some colors that I actually like took the time to like sit and play with it. Like mess with it.
Fenty, you're talking about?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And I tried them dry, I wet them. Like medium, wet them, and then really wet them, and they just work differently depending on how you.
Maybe that's what you do.
Yeah, you need to wet. There's some colors that need to be really, really wet in order for them to work the way you want them.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's one that I was like, oh my gosh, this color is so dry, it's so ugh. But then I like wet it, literally like wet it.
And oh, you're saying like spray the palette?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or your brush, whatever, like really.
Maybe I didn't soak it enough.
yeah, like soak the brush a lot, and you'll be surprised of the difference.
Like I said, I feel like some products are overhyped because a certain celebrity's name is on it. Nothing against Rihanna. I'm just saying I'm seeing that, so I truly try to be kind of unbiased, like not based off of the person making it. It's just the product itself.
So, I agree.
Yeah. The same holds true for Kylie Jenner products. So
I've never tried.
Sometimes they get overhyped.
I've never tried, but I know you have, so.
Yeah. I mean, some of her lipsticks are overly drying.
But. You know, my little sister told me that too. Like, she was just like, there. She goes, my little sister straight up told me I don't like them, so don't buy them.
Oh my god. I'm gonna put some mascara on my lower lash line. This Shayla collab with Maybelline New York, the Colossal Big Shot mascara. I love this. It's amazing. Amazing.
Good choice on my under eye.
Oh yes.
No. I was like, I didn't know what I wanted to do on my under eye area, and then I was like, wait a minute. This is what we're doing.
What do you think about this?
It's so pretty on my eye. Now, for my lips, I'm also gonna try something new. This one's from Maybelline as well. This is from the, I think it's focusing on your face.
Sorry.
It like literally caught your face. Oh, that's probably gonna look really nice. Anyway, I'm gonna use this one. This one's a Super Stay Matte Ink from Maybelline. I hope it goes with the look. If not, we'll just change it.
You're just staring at it.
Ooh, how do you know?
That looks weird.
It looks very weird.
It doesn't look.
It doesn't.
Good.
No.
Totally not even in the color scheme.
But it's nice. I love this. We're gonna change the lip color because it does not go with the look.
I'm gonna use Nicole Girl and Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kits. I'm gonna try to use the three top highlights because they have like pinks in them. I like that. And I'll use a Morphe M510.
Switching it to a nude, I'm going to use a Amore Creamer Place from Dose of Colors in collab with Desi and Katie. We are done and we are ready to go
party.
I don't know where.
We'll find a place.
Yeah. We're probably just gonna go eat
or end up in Target or something.
Or we end up in Target or in some type of makeup store.
Exactly.
Anyway, well, it was awesome just hanging out with you guys. It was awesome having you finally on my show. And she looks so beautiful, doesn't she? Your makeup looks amazing. Thank you for the questions. They were really interesting.
It was fun.
I mean, it was fun answering questions as we were doing makeup.
It was different.
Very different. Anyway, that's it. That's all we got for you. Love you guys, and don't forget to be your own kind of beautiful, and I will see you all on my next video.
Bye.
Bye.